En toch blijkt het mogelijk de mensen van goede wil en smaak voor je te winnen zonder de hulp van hitparades of trendige posters, alleen maar door platen te maken die in dat geval best Boy heten of Oktober. Of door memorabele optredens. Waarom anders stonden onoverzichtelijke hordes fanaten U2 op te wachten bij hun optreden op het Torhout Werchterfestival verleden zomer? U2 is een zeer Ierse groep die zijn eigenheid ontleent aan een combinatie van de inventief ruimtelijke gitaarklank van een jongen die maar liefst The Edge heet, de wonderlijke fraseringen van de heldhaftige zanger Bono Vox, de functionele basstuw van Adam Clayton en het imposante slagwerk van de minderjarige drummer Larry. In afwachting van hun nieuwe LP, die waarschijnlijk War zal heten en rond kerstmis op verschijnen staat, een blikvanger over U2, gemaakt in Torhout, de dag waarop Bono zonder stem zat.
Because my voice is gone, as you can hear it, it's gone, that I felt it's important to try and break through in another way. You know, sometimes people don't listen to you with your voice, so you do anything you want, you climb up on things. You could even climb up here. You see, people would follow you and they pay much more attention to you when you're up here. So I did whatever I wanted and I sit down and Whatever you do, once you climb up, things happen. But I would like to say that I tried to get across to communicate, because there's too many groups, they don't communicate. They try, they hide behind their haircuts, behind the fashion, behind their pose. U2 is about giving yourself 100%. I love those people, and they've paid money in to see us, and they deserve our best. My voice is gone. I am going to have to go. But first, I have a present. I have a present for him. Hold on.
Surprise. Oh, really? Thanks. I knew. That's the right present for a Calypso band.
That's for you and for your viewers back home. And all I would say is I have to go now to the doctor to fix my voice. What do you call your music?
I think what U2 stands, I think we're a rock and roll band. I think you can get caught up in defining, you know, what people do, etc. But, I mean, essentially, it's music and it's communicating with people. And I don't... I mean, like, New Wave is as nice a name as anything else, but I think we are a rock and roll band.
You're calling a lot of good groups from England. I call the Boomtown Rats, the Undertones, Stiff Little Fingers, U2. Is there a reason for... Is there a good climate or something?
Larry, maybe?
Yeah, I don't really think so, no. I think that's very few Irish bands in comparison to, say, Britain. Yes.
But you're very personal. Is it maybe more difficult to stay yourself or be yourself in London or something like that?
Ooh, that is possible, yeah, because you're outside the British scene. Yeah. It makes for better bands, I think. Yeah.
I think it's an advantage, certainly, when you're starting off, to not be caught up in the centre of attention that you get in London. The press centres there, music press,
yes.
All the recording companies, you know, the whole live thing as well. If you're a young band in London, before you're ready, you can find yourself being, you know, put in newspapers, being offered recording contracts. It took us maybe a year and a half before we were prepared and ready to take on things like, you know, major music press, yeah, interviews, and recording company things. So, you know, it was an advantage. It was like a haven for us to come in from Dublin.
Is fun a mean word to you?
We're not about escapism as a band. We're very, very aware of the things that are happening in the world around us. But at the same time, we hate being negative as people. We're very positive in our outlook. No matter how bad things seem, we're always, you know, looking on the bright side.
Yeah.
But fun, I think there is an element of fun. It probably doesn't come across so easily on the albums, but certainly I think in interviews you can you can see.
Hospital.
Yes.
A lot of us need hospitals.
Yes.
A lot of people need hospitals in more ways than one. But he says I will be able to sing tomorrow.
That's fantastic.
Very, very happy. I'm
brilliant.
ons, beste kijker, niet belet u aan te sporen tot het schrijven van brieven met kritieken, suggesties, tips, suggesties of kritieken. De 20 snelste brieven worden beantwoord met LP's als daar zijn een picture disc van AC/DC, een gewone plaat van Steel Pulse, 5 van Shalamar en 5 van Phil Collins. Hij hoort de stem van zijn meester en verdwijnt in de donkere nacht, die goede Filou. Dit was Pop Electron. Slaap wel.